Hi everyone, this is Belal Khan and you are watching Simplified Coding. In this video, we will learn testing our view models. And as you can see in my project, I have created a new spend view model. This spend view model takes the spends tracker data source. And this data source we created in the last video using our spend DAO. So this data source has two functions. One is to add a new spend to the database, and another one is to get the last 20 spends from the database. Now inside the view model as well, I have only two functions. One is to add a spend, and next one is to get the last 20 spends. And one more thing I have in my view model, that is this last 20 spends live data. So when we will fetch the last 20 spends from the database, we will observe the data using this live data. Now we need to test this thing, and to test it again, we will do the same thing. We will create a test class, and this time also we need to create a test class inside Android test folder because our view model requires the spends tracker data source that requires our database, and to create the database we need context. So what I will do is I will right click on the spend view model class. I will go to generate. Then I will select test. Now I will create spend view model test. Now let's hit OK. And this time we will select the Android test folder. Now we have our test class ready. And again, I will delete this JUnit assert import because we are not using it. And again, we need to annotate this class using run with, and we will use the Android JUnit 4 class. Like this, and we also need to extend test case to our class because it is a test class. Now here inside this class, I want to test my view model. So first I will define a private late init var, that is my view model. So the type is spend view model. Now I will override the setup function. So we have public override fun setup. So let's write it here, public override fun setup, and this is the function. Now inside this function, we will set up the test. That means we will create the view model and we will create everything that is required to create our view model. Now you can see to create view model, we need this spends tracker data source. And to create the spends tracker data source, we need our spend DAO. And for the spend DAO, we need our database. So let's go to view model test, and here first I will create the database. But to create the database, we need context. So the first thing that we will get here is the context. So first we will get the context like this, and then we will create our database. So I'll create db equals to room dot in memory database builder. The first parameter is context. The next parameter is the database itself. So here I will pass spend database class dot Java. Then finally we will build the database. But this time I will also call allow main thread queries. Now I have defined here allow main thread queries because I do not want to switch threads just for testing, and that is why I have defined that allow main thread queries. Now using the DB, we can get our spends tracker data source. So we will write here val data source equals to spends tracker data source, and it takes our DAO, and we can get the DAO from the DB. So we have the data source now. Now we can create our view model. So here I will write view model equals to spends view model. Like this, and we will pass the data source. That's it. So we have the view model. I also need to annotate this function as before because I want to run it before every test. Now we will create our test function that we will annotate with test. And finally, I will create here a function that is called fun test view or spend view model. You can name your function anything that you want. So this is my function that will test my view model. Now inside my view model, I am adding a spend and I am getting the last 20 spends. Now this time also, I will do the same thing as we did in the previous video. I will add a spend using the view model and then we will fetch the last 20 spends using view model. And then we will check if the added spend exists or not in the last 20 spends. So let's do it. Now we have added the spend. After adding the spend, we will call the function that is get last 20 spends. Now we need to check if our added spend exists in the last 20 spends or not. Now to get the last 20 spends from ViewModel, what we will do is we will call our live data. So we have the last 20 spends. Now we need to get value from this live data. And to do this thing, we need to create one more separate function. So I got this function from, you know, sample code, but I will write the code just to make sure that you understand the concept. So inside my Android test package, I will create a new file and I will name it live data test utils, or you can name it anything that you want. We don't need a class. We just need to create a function and it will be an extension function of live data. So here I will create live data of type T dot get or await value, because here in case of live data, we need to wait until it gets the value. And we need to define a generic function that will work for all live datas. So that is why I will define here type as T. So we have our function that is get or await value. Now the first thing here that we will do is we will define a data var. So we have var data of type T and the initial value is null. And we will return this T from this function. So we will return data as T like this. And we also need to define the return type for this function, that is T. Now here we need to wait until our live data gets the value. And to wait for it, I will use a countdown latch that we use for waiting for other threads to complete. So here I will create a latch. Let's say we have latch equals to countdown latch, and I want to wait just for one thread. So whenever we will get our observer called and we will get the live data value, we will stop waiting with the help of this latch. Now here I will write latch dot await like this. Now this latch will wait until the live data gets the value. But there may be cases when our live data will never get the value. And to solve this issue, I will wait for 2 seconds only. So I will define here 2, and for the time unit, I will define seconds. So I have time unit dot seconds here. Now in case our live data never gets the value, I will throw an exception. So here I will throw timeout exception. Live data never gets its value, or you can write whatever message you want. So that's it. Now finally, we will create an observer. So let's create an observer here. I will create val observer equals to observer, and we need to create it as an anonymous inner class. So we will use object and then not live data, but observer of type T like this. And inside the observer, we will implement the function that is onChanged. I think we don't need this parenthesis here like this. Now inside the onChanged function, we will get the live data value and we will assign this value to our data. So here I will write data equals to T like this, and then we will remove the observer. So here I will write this @ get or await value dot remove observer, and we will pass this, that is our current observer. And after this, we will call the countdown function in our latch so that it will stop waiting for the live data value. So here we will write latch dot countdown like this. Now finally, we will attach this observer to our live data. So here we will write this dot observe forever because this is our live data, and we will put our observer like this. Now finally, if we throw this timeout exception, then also we will remove the observer. So we have try and finally. Inside finally, we will remove the observer. So we will remove the observer like this. And that's it. Our function to test live data is ready. And now we can use this function to get the value from the live data. So here we will come back to our ViewModel test, and here we will call the function get or await value. Now this function will give us the live data value, and it is a list of spends, and from the list we can call find function, and inside find function we can define it equals to not it, actually it dot amount equals to 170, and it dot description equals to bot or the same string. So I will copy paste just to make sure I won't do any mistake. So if this add function worked successfully, we will get the added spend inside this last 20 spends live data. And we will store the found element inside a result. Now finally, we can assert that result not equals to null, and it is true. We need to import the assert that function, and that's it. So we are asserting that result is not equals to null. Because if we found something like this, we will get some result. If not, we will get null. So if the result is not null, that means our code is working absolutely fine. Now our test function is ready, but before running the test, I need to define a rule. So here we will define a rule inside our test class. And that is, to define a rule, we use @ get and then rule like this. And I will define here val instant task executor rule, and it is instant task executor rule like this. Now if you don't know what is this, then it is a JUnit test rule that swaps the background executor used by architecture components, and it swaps it with a different one which executes each task synchronously. So for testing, I want to execute everything synchronously because it is required. So that is why I have defined this rule here. Now let's run the test. And make sure you have connected to a real device or an emulator, because to run this test, a real device or an emulator is required. So the tests are running and you can see the test passed. So it is working absolutely fine. Our test passed. That means the view model is working as expected. So that is how you can test view models, your view models, and you can write as many test cases as you want or as required. So that is all for this video, friends. In case you want the source code, then you can get it from the link that is given in the description of this video. And I hope you found this video helpful and learned something new. So if you found this video helpful, then please give me a thumbs up. Subscribe to this channel if you're not already a subscriber, and you can share this video with all your friends. So thanks for watching, everyone. This is Bilal Khan now signing off.